Saturday afternoon, about noontime, up here in Trenton. They had me deadhead from Cottersville up here to Trenton to Miller to grab this loaded trailer, and I'm heading to Salem, Virginia for Monday morning delivery. So I got my straps here, and I'm about to strap down this load. Let's see what we have in here. It's only saying it's 37,000 pounds, I think. Looks like we're hauling some old English 800. Never heard of that before. And the legendary Pabst Blue Ribbon, and a couple other things in back there. Let's see, what's that? Milwaukee's Best, I guess. And some, is that Miller Highlight, maybe? All right, everyone, we have, put the steering wheel down here. I guess it ain't really gonna matter. But, hey, we got it loaded. We got it strapped down. Gotta do my paper real quick. And then head on down. I'm 37,142. That's what my total weight is, so not too shabby. She's a bit warm up here. A bit warm up here in Trenton, Ohio, folks. But yeah. So anyways, like I said earlier, there we go. I deadheaded up from Cottersville. No loads in the south. Tons of loads up here. So that's what I'm doing. And I'm going home on Friday, so I'll be in Virginia tomorrow, hanging out waiting to deliver this Monday morning, and then I don't know what we're gonna do. Gonna go up to Mass on Friday, see the baby girl. She crawled for the first time yesterday, October 19th. We got a video of her crawling across the floor, so she's almost, should be 8 months old on the 7th of November, so she's growing up fast, but she's moving. So she's a moving now. So anyways, hey, good morning, everyone. See that duration? 17 hours, 51 minutes. Yeah, that means I've been stopped for 17 hours, 51 minutes, almost 18 hours here in Beckwell, Ohio at the Loves. I shut down here last night about 4:15. The slow doesn't deliver until Monday at 9 a.m. in Salem, Virginia, which I'm only 220 miles from there right now, so we're just going to take off and run down to Virginia today and get a park out of Love's, be about an hour out, but I'm like, eh, I'm just going to do a 34, no sense moving, and then I'll be able to run next week, well, this coming week. I am going home on Friday. Another cold southern boy I see there.
This is a hot southern boy.
Isn't that a cute tiger on your dash?
That's in memoriam for my dead cat.
Hey, our special guest, Mr. Corey Collins from my class, has rolled on into town. It's like a pro, backing in to the hole. Come a long way since that first week at MTI school in Eden, North Carolina. Back in May. Now we're in October, almost November. He's super trucker. He's got the big antennas on his truck. Mr. Tiger is a pet. Hey everyone, say hi to Corey.
Hi, Corey.
All right, I'll catch you guys later. Good morning, everyone, from Salem, Virginia, in the Blue Ridge Mountains at Blue Ridge Distributors. Again, another early delivery. Got here 2 hours before my appointment. Got Rin and Doc. They're about, let's see, what are they? We're about half done right now.
A new message has arrived.
And a new message has arrived. But yeah, just want to show you the mountains this morning. She's gorgeous. Shenandoah Valley, the beginning of Shenandoah Valley. But hey, I'll let you know where we're heading next. Waiting on another dispatch. Here in Horicon, Wisconsin. Horicon, that's how you pronounce it. Horicon, Wisconsin. Just picked up this trailer and dropped. You can't really see, but there's Millis trailer right there. I just dropped off. It's John Deere plant. So I left you last in, where was I? Oh, the Blue Ridge, Blue Ridge Mountain in Shenandoah Valley. Unloaded there, went down to Virginia Ringle Gold, grabbed a load of bottles, and brought that up to West Allis. Dropped that off. Then I had to come up from West Allis, which is right outside of Milwaukee, to Richfield to get empty. Didn't have an empty in Richfield. Then came up to Beaver Dam, Wisconsin, grabbed the empty at Walmart. Came down here, John Deere. Taking this John Deere load to a guy in Indiana. Meeting him at a service plaza, giving him this load. This is going to the Jersey area. And I guess I'm going to pick up his load and go to somewhere in Connecticut. But I'll let you know when I get that load. Hey, good morning. Yeah, it's Thursday morning, coming to you from Jamesville, Indiana. It's about 32 degrees this fine morning. Got my fresh brewed coffee, got my shower already. And let's see, last time I left you, I was up in Horicon, that's how I've been told to pronounce it, Horicon, Wisconsin, at the John Deere Manufacturing Facility where they make John Deere lawnmowers and gators. And I met up with another driver in Indiana on I-80, 90 there in the rest area. Took his load, he's going to New Jersey, was the load I picked up yesterday. And I got his load and I'm heading two stops in New York and then one in North Haven, Connecticut. Then I'm going home to see my baby girl. It's been almost 2 months since I've been back to Massachusetts to see her. So, a little frosty on the cat this morning, but that's where I'm headed. I'm hoping to make one stop today in New York and then just before the Connecticut border. And then I got another one in that area, which I know I'll definitely not make today. So, we'll see what happens. But I'm gonna get down, get my pre-trip done, get on down the road, folks. I got a lot of miles to put behind me. Can't wait to get home, see my baby girl. And hey, Red Sox won again last night. That's 2-0 against LA, guys. Two more games and we'll take the series and we'll swipe them. Down in the comments, let me know what your predictions are. If you think the Red Sox are gonna swipe the LA Dodgers in the World Series or not. Back at the Blue Beacon in Hubbard, Ohio on the Pennsylvania PA line. Getting ready to go in Pennsylvania here pretty soon, another couple miles. But hey, I'm waiting in line. I'm doing a 30-minute break and I'm cooking some bacon and eggs. So I am using my 30-minute break very wisely. Getting three things done at the same time. 30-minute break, DOT required, getting a truck wash, and cooking myself some food.
trust me once. It's left a bitter taste, and now you push me, I will tear you down. If you're mad enough to fight, then you're mad enough to fall. What are you gonna do with your back against the wall? You played the game so far, now come and claim your prize. There's no think you know it all. Talk will only take you so far. Before you have to prove it, this time I'll watch you lose it. You're out of line and out of time. Just walk away while you still have your pride. If you're mad enough to fight, then you're mad.
Friday morning, folks, at stop number 2 here in Poughkeepsie, New York, at Adams Power Equipment. It's in the city. I guess you want to call it a city. It's 7:30. They're supposed to open at 8, but no one's here. And I don't see a loading dock. So I'm guessing they're going to unload it with the flatbed there. But we'll see. It's nice and chilly. It's about 29 degrees out. I moved to the south for a reason, to get away from this cold. And what would you know? I am still here. I'm still in the north dealing with it. It's a pretty sunrise starting to come up this morning. The old girl, she's all polished up. But yeah, I'll open it up and I'll show you what I'm unloading here while we wait. Alrighty, everyone. This is what we're unloading.
The Gator.
This one's camouflage. But this is how they hook them in. They put these blocks on the floor and they nail them in. Then they put a little piece of strap around it. Come on, this side, a little more room. But yeah, Gator and all, I mean, they even put the key in it, so. See the lights there? She's good to go, got power. And here's another one. And this Gator. And this lawnmower will be going to my next delivery in North Haven, Connecticut. So, let's wait and see how long before someone shows up here so we can get unloaded and get going. So stop number 2, guys. I didn't have to, we didn't use the flatbed. So we came in here. I had to whip it around here in this tight little parking lot, come down here, back up, and then I had to drive that way and then back over here to this loading dock. Yeah. It is now 8:15. These guys do not come in early. They come in at 8 o'clock. I guess they work banker hours. But yeah, headed back up there. One left, and a lawnmower, and then 2-hour ride to baby girl for some time off. But yeah, fun times. And the road even coming up in here is a pain in the butt, let me tell you, to get up in here. So there we go. I think this is a real issue with a couple weeks ago. I have to look at my numbers, but I think it is. But hey, 2-hour ride now to North Haven, Connecticut. So, gonna put the hammer down and get going. Hey, look at these shiny rims, guys. Alrighty. Hey, everyone. Here in my parking spot in Weymouth, Massachusetts, right down the road from Gillette Stadium. But all the drops are done. I felt like a city driver today in the tight spots that I had to go. But, hey, we got the job done. I'm going to do my paperwork and call Lily up, have her come pick me up. And I'm off until Wednesday morning. So, we'll catch you back then. We'll start a new video on Wednesday. So, I hope you all have a great weekend. Go Red Sox, playing in Game 3 tonight. Patriots playing Monday Night Football. So, let's see what happens. Catch you all later.